Hello friends, welcome to my channel Accountancy for Sure. Today we will discuss calculation of interest on partner's capital from T.S. Grewal, page number 2.83, question number 27. In this, a balance sheet on 31st of March 2020 is given and the two partners are Neelkant and Mahadev. Their capital accounts are given and also their current account is given. So when current account is given, it means their capital accounts are fixed, and the question is asking to calculate interest on capital at the rate of 5% for the year ended 31st of March 2020. So it is a direct question, it is just a simple calculation. Neelkant's capital is rupees 10 lakh. On this 10 lakh, 5% interest on capital is allowed, which is 50,000 rupees. Same way, Mahadev's capital is also rupees 10 lakh. And interest on capital is calculated 10 lakh multiplied by 5%, that is also 50,000. That was a very simple question to calculate. Now come to question number 28. In this question, a balance sheet is given on 31st of March 2020 and the two partners are long and short. Their capital account is given in the balance sheet, it means that is the closing capital, and the question asks to calculate interest on capital at the rate of 8% per annum. And it also says during the year long withdrew rupees 40,000 and short withdrew rupees 50,000, and profit for the year was rupees 1,50,000, out of which 1 lakh was transferred to general reserve, and this general reserve is shown in the balance sheet. So we will have to calculate the opening capital balance so that we can calculate interest on capital on it. So first we will write closing capital balance. Of long is 1,20,000 and short is 1,40,000. We will add drawings to it. As suggested in the question, long has withdrawn rupees 40,000 and short has withdrawn rupees 50,000. So if we calculate this, now it is 1,60,000 and here 1,90,000. But they have also distributed profit. Though profit was rupees 1,50,000, but out of this 1,50,000, 1 lakh is already transferred to general reserve, which is shown in the liability side of balance sheet. It means it is not included in this closing amount. Only the remaining 50,000 we will subtract. Profit for the year in the ratio 1:1, because profit sharing ratio is not given in the question. So we will distribute this 50,000 in the ratio 1:1, so 25,000 and 25,000. If we subtract, we will get 1,45,000 for long and 1,65,000 for short. Now these two figures are the opening capital balance. Opening capital balances. That is, it is on 1st of April 2019. This closing balance is on which date? It is on 31st 3 20. Now interest we have to calculate. Interest on capital for long is equal to 1,45,000 into, as asked in the question, 8%, we will get rupees 11,600. And for short, it is 1,65,000 into 8 divided by 100, that is equal to rupees 13,200. That is our answer. Now let us see the next question, question number 29 from T.S. Grewal, page number 2.83. Now here Two partners, Moli and Bholi, contribute rupees 20,000 and 10,000 respectively towards capital, and they decide to allow interest on capital at the rate of 6% per annum, and their profit sharing ratio is 2:3, and the net profit for the year is given 1500. Now there are two conditions we have to solve the question for. First is that where there is no agreement except for interest on capital. In this, if we calculate interest on capital for Moli, 20,000 into 6%, it will be 1200, and for Bholi it is 10,000 at the rate of 6%, it is 600. So total interest on capital is 1800. This 1800 is more than our net profit. So when there is no agreement except for interest on capital, it means we have to restrict our interest on capital to 1500. So in this case, this rupees 1500 will be divided between Moli and Bholi in their capital ratio. Capital ratio is 2:1. 20,000 is to 10,000. 2:1. So Moli will get rupees 1000 and Bholi will get rupees 500. 2 interest on capital, Moli and Bholi. Moli will get rupees 1000 and Bholi will get rupees 500. So 1500, we cannot charge or we cannot allow them interest on capital more than the net profit as per the agreement. So this 1500, which is less than the total interest on capital, will be distributed between the partners in their capital ratio. Which ratio? Capital ratio. Now the second part of the question says that when there is an agreement that the interest on capital as a charge, it means irrespective of net profit, we have to charge interest on capital full. So by net profit as transferred from profit and loss account, it is 1500, and 2 interest on capital. Two partners, Moli and Bholi. It is, as we have discussed earlier, it is 1200 for Moli and 600 for Bholi. Together it is 1800. Now debit side is more than the credit side, so it will appear as a loss, by loss, and it will be shared between the partners in the ratio 2:3. So Moli and Bholi, on the debit side it is 1800 and on the credit side it is only 1500. So if we insert 300 rupees here, that is balancing figure, both the sides will be equal. Now there is a loss of 300 which will be distributed between both the partners in the ratio 3:2. So Moli will get 120 rupees loss and Bholi will get 180 rupees loss. That's it. Now let us see the next question, question number 30. It says that Amit and Bhramit started business on 1st of April 2019 with capitals of rupees 15 lakh and 9 lakh respectively. On 1st October 2019, they decided that their capital should be rupees 12 lakh each. Necessary adjustments in capital in capitals were made by introducing or withdrawing by check. Interest on capital is allowed at the rate of 8% per annum. Compute interest on capital for the year ended 31st of March 2020. Interest on capital for the year ended 31st 3 20, for the first partner Amit. See, from 1st of April 2019 to 30th of September 2019, his capital was 15 lakh. Opening capital for the first 6 months. So at the rate of 8% for this 6 months, from April to September, it is 6 months, April, May, June, July, August, September, 6 months, it will be rupees 60,000. Now from 1st of October 2019 to 31st of March 2020, they have made their capitals 12 lakh. So 12 lakh at the rate of 8% for 6 months. Remaining 6 months, it is 48,000. So if we add, we get 108,000 as Amit's interest on capital. Similarly, we can calculate for the other partner, next partner, Bhramit. From 1st of April 2019 to 30th of September 2019, Bhramit was having capital of rupees 9 lakh. At the rate of 8% for these 6 months, interest on capital will be 36,000. Now, on 1st of October 2019 to 31st of March 2020, he increased his capital balance to 12 lakh by bringing 3 more lakhs. So for the remaining 6 months, at the rate of 8% for 6 months, his calculation will be 48,000. So first 6 months plus the last 6 months, his total will be 84,000 as interest on capital. So these are the two amounts, interest on capital, for the partner Amit and Bhramit.